So here we are with a 2020 Mattel Dreammobile based on the Dream Machine from the 1950s as comparative scale.
Dark.
Linemar Elegant Miniatures Space Missile, number 111. That's gorgeous. And I'm not going to lie to you, I pay some money for these, but I gotten clocked on some vintage Golden Astronaut or SpaceX Pippin range vehicles and felt like, you know what, I want something nice. Elegant Miniatures number 113 space tank box. Seen some wear. Look at that. My God. Okay, so this end looks in better shape. So this is the one I'm going to open. And this, yes. Oh, it's a little drawer. Oh my God. Try to keep it on the camera screen. So it's a little drawer box. This thing can open like an old matchbox. Exciting. This is exciting. It's a Linemar space missile. It is near mint condition. This can likely be found. I do not see any markings on the bottom. I'm going to handle these as little as possible. So we're going to be very careful. So that damaged end. And I've waited quite a while to see this. The vendor did have pictures of these. These were open a while ago. I'm gonna pull that safely off to the side and just marvel at this thing. Interesting. Look at the bottom. It looks like there's a pin holding the antenna in place, so it's not going to fall out. I was concerned that the antenna might fall out. Is there some marking there? No, I don't think there's any markings anywhere. Linemar space tank. I was reading about the Elegant Miniatures line in general, which includes cars and trucks, and those I know the construction vehicles are 1-90 scales. I'm not sure what scale that this is meant to be in exactly. As a comparison, here's the little space tank from the lunar landing miniature playset, and I don't know if when I was making the video, if I was so excited that I wasn't really paying attention. There is a Marx logo there on the bottom of it. Soft plastic with the hard plastic dome and its operator figure and soft plastic antenna array, which is basically the same sort of thing you got going on here with the Linemar example. Once again, a domed operator's cabin and then some sort of a revolving antenna behind it. That is the most dominant feature on the vehicle. I almost think it's a bit much, But the thing is beautiful. It's absolutely gorgeous. I cannot put enough praise into the quality of the appearance of both of these here in front of me. It's absolutely incredible. I can't see if there's any like Air Force markings or anything. So I guess not. Kind of hoping I could present it as one towing the other, but there's nothing like a hitch. There doesn't have to be. Box. Number 113 space tank by Linemar, and I'd gotten out, you know, my smallest marks space characters, kind of hoping maybe they might approach the scale for it, and they do not. Here's an LP Toys 1:64 scale astronaut, and he's way too big even. And here's a copy of a giant toys soldier, and even that's... I actually do have a little teensy thing. That was a dollhouse component, and I'll have to get it out and see if he maybe... There they are with the... Hot Wheels Dream Machine, and you can see that the scale difference is drastic. Huge 1:64 scale compared to those two. I also got out an LP Toys lunar module, and that's actually kind of nice. Interesting. Have fun working on these. Utilizing them as photographic subjects in space art, and amongst other things, it can be used in a perspective experiment to make it look like they're really far away. Use the Mark's space tank, you know, and there's his squadron mate there up on the next ridge, dragging the space rocket. And use that to suggest scale and distance between the two. Let's take a look at the box graphics. The boxes are probably even more rare than the vehicles. Linemar, so that's essentially an adapted Mark's Toys logo there on the corner. Linemar, best by far. The printing on the back as well. One of the many miniatures. Do you have all of them? That's Mark's Toys. Top right there, almost in itself. Another look at the space missile. Linemar Incorporated, Japan. Wow. Linemar, best by far. What does that say? Elegant miniatures. Worth every rusted nickel, man. Ooh, there we go. Fantastic. I believe 1961 was a date that I saw on a different vehicle from their space. See, there was another moon vehicle. There's a flying saucer. There's a trailer with a satellite on it, and another one with a rocket or a missile on it, and one of them at least I saw somewhere on the internet with a 1961 date associated with it, and that sounds about right. I'm under the impression that the company existed as a subsidiary of Mark's until 1968, and then I think another toy company absorbed it. All right, so stop the presses. Taking some pictures of the vehicles and their boxes before making sure that they are safely secured. And there we see a number, M18, on the back that I had not noticed earlier. It's a decorative flourish there rather than M18. Not sure what that refers to. No, I guess not. I was wondering if those were numbers or letters or something. But what made me stop and look was glancing at the space missile here up on the side up by the nose. Unmistakable lettering. I guess it says Japan in some sort of stylized manner. I think that's what it says. Pretty sure. Oh, there's something else there at the very end. Is that? Maybe it's just a reflection. And I know, like me, you are already thinking, how is he going to care for these things? And after I'm done with my little photo session here, I'm not even going to leave it out overnight to look at. Usually I would. This is good to leave out because it's almost indestructible. Soft plastic. But those, I wouldn't want to knock those off the bedstand. So each one will get boxed up with its padding. Into a bag, and then I picked out this nook here in a box for now, at least, to hold it safely. Won't get squished, nothing will get spilled on it. Knock on wood. So this worked out good. Here's the tank with the little dollhouse spaceman, and actually comes it or came in that box. I've seen a couple of them since. I'd like to get another one. I'm not sure what the scale is, but it's supposed to be like a present in a box or something like that. A toy in a box for a doll in a dollhouse. And I had a feeling he'd work good. I'm not sure what the scale of any of this stuff is. But yeah, he works pretty good, doesn't he? And we're going to set about trying to find a couple of images that work well enough to be... Like right that right there. Here's a painting. Mission accomplished.